Hello, my name is Mark Lombardi. I'm an engineer here at Keysight Technologies. This video focuses on component testing and how making nonlinear distortion measurements on amplifiers can impact measurement analysis bandwidth. Keysight Technologies provides a wide range of test solutions for aerospace engineers deploying satellite systems. As aerospace engineers strive to update satellite systems to address the ever-growing needs of data, there is a greater focus on high data rate modulation schemes. These typically require bandwidths that can expose amplifier effects that may not impact narrowband signals. For example, nonlinear behaviors over a satellite channel might have little impact on a 5 megabit signal, but render the signal unrecoverable at 500 megabits per second. This can be especially true in the case of space-based platforms when engineers may be focused to trade off amplifier linearity for efficiency. The issue for designers or integrators is to maintain the correct test procedures to be able to address the new system requirements. Many of these new wideband systems employ a digital pre-distortion technique in order to optimize the system throughput. For engineers evaluating amplifiers that will be utilized in these schemes, wideband distortion measurements on prospective amplifiers can be very informative. If the amplifiers used in the design have been selected before the full details of the modulation and signal processing algorithms are finalized, it can be helpful to have a wide range of measurements that help engineers predict the outcome of design decisions. The better the measurements represent the future operational conditions, the closer the system will match expectations. When the distortion properties of an amplifier are measured and understood under the various operational conditions, including supply voltage and temperature, more accurate predictions can be made as to the final system performance. Let's now look at a few of these amplifier measurements using the PXA with the 510 MHz wideband analysis option and the PSA software. To measure the distortion, we measure the input or stimulus and the output or the response of the power amplifier. We then compare the two in order to determine the amount of distortion that has been contributed to the signal by the power amplifier. One way to accomplish this on a single channel vector signal analyzer is by storing the stimulus waveform in the VSA software trace memory and then running the distortion measurements relative to the output response of the power amplifier. This approach allows for an uncorrected test stimulus to be used with very good results. This also makes it possible to make the distortion measurements with signals that more closely represent the modulation type ultimately used in the satellite payload. In order to make these measurements, it's important to not only have enough analysis bandwidth to capture the signal of interest, but also consider capturing the multiple orders of spectral regrowth, especially if that information will be utilized in system signal processing. One example would be digital predistortion. If the modulated signal is 144 MHz and the third order nonlinear impacts will be used in the signal conditioning, the PXA would provide 510 MHz of analysis bandwidth. That's enough bandwidth to capture the 144 MHz wide modulated signal, along with the third order spectral regrowth components. Typical distortion measurements include AM-AM, AM-PM, gain compression, and differential error vector magnitude. Many times these measurements would have been done utilizing two tones as the stimulus and increasing the power to sweep out a curve. But once more of the design decisions have been made, a complex modulated signal similar to what the transponder would use in operation can be also used in a test stimulus. This lets us test with realistic signal dynamics like peak to average power ratio and channel loading of the composite signal. AM-AM shows the stimulus magnitude versus response magnitude, or input versus output. The X value of the points are the magnitude of the stimulus and the Y values are the magnitude in dBm of the response voltage. AM/PM shows phase difference versus the stimulus magnitude. The X value is the magnitude of the stimulus voltage, and the Y value represents the phase difference between the stimulus and the response, shown in degrees. A positive phase difference for a point indicates that the response phase is greater than the stimulus phase for the same corresponding time point. Having an understanding of an amplifier's AM/AM and AM/PM characteristics are important because it directly translates into errors in the data recovered from a modulated signal. Having measurements that cover the nonlinear behaviors of an amplifier can help engineers during the design phase of a communication system, either by matching the modulation to the amplifier behavior or selecting an amplifier whose nonlinear behavior best matches the modulation, a system design can be optimized. Please contact your local Keysight representative to learn more about distortion measurements utilizing the PXA with the wideband option, as well as a full line of test solutions for satellite new space. Thank you.